Halloween used to be a big thing at one time. Of course, we never did any of that stuff, but the older guys used to build roadblocks and...
Where the school is now, where the new school is, it used to be all the pool construction headquarters there, where their eatery and their dormitories where they stayed, and the workers are all part of this expansion of the plant. But anyhow, the kids got the idea they should maybe throw some paper down the outhouse there, and they used to have these string of outhouses all, they were all one unit there, but there was about 9 units in it, so they did that and started that on fire. That caused quite a creation there when the flames were licking about 40 feet in the air. So.
I heard stories from the older guys about one of their favorite pastimes too was to sit on the rock cut west of here and throw rocks on the trains. It didn't matter if it was a passenger train, right? Because I never did any of that. This is the old guys.
Yeah, right.
Well, you had to entertain yourself. You know, this, the thing is, I know we used to go over there. They had them pump scooters. Mm-hmm. We used to get them, put them on the tracks, and upset the CPR police. They'd be after you.
Just look forward to the rail strike so we could get on the tracks and no trains were coming. Play around.
Oh, they always looked after all the kids. It didn't matter whether you're, you know, if you're, you used to spend a lot of time, you go to sleep over at somebody's place when you're younger, and you had a friend, you'd go spend there, so it was like kind of like your second mother.
A lot of the women had an extra weight on them too, as a lot of our fathers worked shift work. And trying to raise a family when father was trying to sleep during the day because he worked nights was something in itself. I remember going to one particular house and it was daddy sleeping. He'd been on nights. Once in a while you'd see him come out of the bedroom, look like a grizzly coming out of a den. But they had that to, that was something else that the mothers had to look after, keep the kids out of trouble. Another thing I never got involved in was, because it was the older guys, was the bow and arrow fights down in the old powerhouse.
Well, they're pretty good.
Uh-huh. I was never allowed to go there.
Did they make their own bows and arrows?
Oh, yeah, make your own bows and arrows. And play Tarzan. You had a rope hung and strung from the ceiling there, and that, there used to be a pit in there in the center, but... And you'd swing across. Worked pretty good when you... got enough momentum, but if you didn't, then you'd lose your grip, you'd fall in this pit. Yeah, there's, we spent a lot of time down there, playing down there, and there used to be little, you get inside there in the silos over here, the old silos, we used to get in there and they'd have a BB gun, and if you, one guy had the BB gun and everybody else would take off and hide. It was all dark in there. Chase him around with his BB gun in there. One recollection there of, you know, where the superintendent's house is, used to be up close to the hotel there. It was the last house on the row. And then their dormitory was just this to the east of the superintendent's house. But anyway, we went up. There was about 8 of us went up there, and we decided there was a big rock out of there, and we thought, well, it'd be kind of nice if we could release this rock, because we were always doing it, go up the mountain and roll rocks down. But this one was pretty good size. It was probably 3.5 feet high and probably 4 feet across. But we spent pretty well the whole day getting that to finally go, but finally when it released, it started going down there and knocking trees over, and then we thought, oh, we maybe started something here that we shouldn't have. And the superintendent's house had a woodshed that was attached to the kitchen, demolished that woodshed, went through there and across the road, smashed into the dormitory, and Swiss Mueller was in bed and knocked him out of bed. And of course, we were all going to be tech different directions. And they had the police come to the school, wanted to identify who was involved, and it got a lot of us in a lot of problems. It was a good thing it wasn't another few feet over. It would have took the kitchen right off. Uh-huh. You know, it was a kind of a dumb move, but it was amazing, though. You know, as much as the younger ones did hear that there wasn't more that were killed over the years. You know, I mean, because we spent a lot of time crossing over the river in the wintertime, and of course that was a no-no. You were always told, don't go near the river in the wintertime. And there used to be ice, and then one little stream open, running where the water. We used to go over there and jump over that, and go over the other side of the river. You know, it was fortunate. Like I said, there wasn't a lot of kids that drowned doing that. But
we were playing in the boxcars down there too. We found the car mover one time. We were able to move about one boxcar. You could move with a car mover if you got things just right. So we found that we could move this boxcar a few yards and then let it roll back. And then it was more of part of the game was to, if you could jump from the moving car to one that was stationary, that was even better. Shake my head now to think of the consequences of that.
Scary.
Yeah. Like Wayne says, playing by the river, summer and winter, for that matter.
It wasn't, like you said. You know, the games you invented weren't always the best ones, but they were fun at the time, you know. Step old Nollerville there, almost over where the old dairy barn used to be, but there's that used to be a little bit of a road go up towards the ski hill. And there was an old car in there. I don't know, it was probably a 36 Dodge Pell passenger car, but and the motor was gone and it sat there. But anyway, we all decided it would be fun to push this thing up the hill and then jump in it and ride down. So I don't know, there was probably 12 or 14 of us, but we used to get in there and push this old car and then get up there and jump in it and run down and hit a tree. So, but it was something to do. You were trying to find things that you could have fun at. When you're boys, it don't take much sometimes to.
And all the time we spent on the railway, you know, west and east, going fishing or just fooling around. Nobody ever got tangled up with the train either. That was a big no-no, stay off the tracks, but we did it anyway.
Don Elycraft and I went down one time. We're going to go up to Eau Claire. So we walked. It was, I don't know, it was probably around minus 20, something like that. But it was good going east because the wind was at your back. And we got down there and we were going to cross on the logs and go up to Eau Claire. But we got over there all right. But then the logs weren't that solid, and they started moving around, and we went to come back. And we started to come across to him, and we thought, oh, this isn't a good idea. And then he got the idea we should wade the river, go up a little bit where it was shallow. Well, we went in there, and we waded up to about our knees, and then we thought, well, we can't get across there. So then we come back. And we finally skinnied across these logs. We finally got across there, but by that time we were soaking wet. But yeah, I can still remember walking west home and their blue jeans were frozen solid. You were like a tin soldier. Yeah. But we got home and we went in and we used to have the old wood stove and pull the oven door down, put your feet on there, and tried to thaw them out, and then they'd start burning because the frost was coming out of them. And then, of course, you had to explain about where you were and how you got wet. So you're in trouble there, too. So
that reminds me of a of a river story too. It wasn't anybody from here was involved, but a bunch of us were at the sandy beach one day, and we could see these, I think there was three guys on the other shore, and they walked into the river and proceeded to swim across. That was quite a swim. If you did it in the wrong place, which was quite a ways above the rapids where it was wide. They swam across okay, but the water's cold. And they climbed out and they talked and this and that. And, one of them said, well, I guess we better walk around and go back to the other side. I said, no, this is not a lake, this is a river. You gotta cross back again. They weren't very happy, but again, they managed to swim back across and they were safe. But consequences could have been bad there too. There's one young fellow found out a few years after that. They were going to swim across too, and he did it with his blue jeans, didn't take his blue jeans off. And he was a fairly skinny kid, didn't have any real insulation on his body. And he got partway across. And I don't know, it took him, I don't know, 2 weeks to find him?
Yeah.
Fortunately, he was the only one I remember.
Vince, the badger, he fell through in the winter time, and they found him on the trash racks in Seabee in the spring.
And there was one of the Bapti family, Francis, younger brother, would have been an older brother, I guess. I think his name was Marshall, drowned down here. But he was just a small child, right? Well before my time, I only remember reading about it.
Yeah.
All the hijinks that we went through at the river, as you say, crossing the logs and ice and what have you, playing around in half-leaky boats and you name it, not too many tragedies.
Well, we were going to, when I went to school in Canmore, we finished grade 10 there, and then we decided in the spring there, we decided that maybe when the ice lent out that we'd ride an iceberg down from Canmore to Exxon, but we started out, but anyhow, our iceberg kind of busted up, so we kind of canceled that idea, which was probably pretty good. We might have never made it anyhow. So
I don't realize how slow that river goes once it gets.
Well,
yeah,
yeah, yeah,
pretty flat, especially if these winds blow. Yeah. It doesn't make any headway at all, hardly.
Rubber ice. Another one the kids used to play when they were little is play rubber ice. When you get a body of water, and when the ice is not really solid, it'll give. Eh? So when you run across it, it's going up and down like that. So the deal was is see how many could make it across before somebody fell through.
Something similar to seeing how deep the water really was with your gumboots on, right?
Well, a lot of times we played it on the sloughs, but it wasn't a matter so much as how deep the water was. Like maybe the water was only that deep, but you used to sink in the mud too, uh-huh. You know. So.
My dad doing that one time. We were on a slough out east, and he went through the ice with the skates on. And into the mud.
Yep.
You know, try to get out of the mud, up onto the ice, and off of there. Should have known better.